why name Krishna Supreme Court? Because most employers dismiss their employees without observing due process of law, as long as there's a valid reason. Alam kasi ng mga lawyer na, sige, dismiss mo na. Hindi na naman yung marirestate. There is no longer trust and confidence. Wala nang trust and confidence. Nagnakaw siya. So, bawal ng reinstatement. Hindi makakabalik yan sa atin. Pero that is not the issue. Valid nga yung ground for dismissal, but you fail to observe the due process. Therefore, you'll be liable for separation pay and exemplary damages. To set an example that employers will no longer do that now.
Sir,
yung
po ba mga fundraising campaign na may proceeds na pupunta sa program
or sa yung fundraising? No. Because that activities are considered for charitable purposes, religious purposes. Actually, in the old case decided by the Supreme Court, a local ordinance.
Halimbawa kung kayo, bingo or di ba gambling yun?
Halimbawa, bingo.
Okay.
Bingo.
Raffle
draw. Not bingo. Raffle draw.
Raffle draw.
Okay. According to the NIRC kasi, ano sabi na NIRC? All the income of religious, non-stock, non-profit, religious, charitable, are exempted from corporate income tax as long as that the proceeds are used for religious, charitable purposes. As long. But the issue is there is probably we will be charged for illegal gambling because there is no permit from the mayor. Let's just ask for permit from the mayor.
Aba po ng red sa raffle draw, may hindi may tax na meron.
Kasi yung prices.
The tax will go will pertain not on the proceeds, income of the religious organization, but on the proceeds of the winner. Ang tinatax, hindi yung nagbenta ng bingo card o ano man. Ang nanalo. That's why you will within ABS-CBN, you will be subjected to final tax of 20%. So kung nanalo ka ng Audi, 10 million yun. Hindi ko makuha yung Audi kasi nandun yung taga BIR. Goya, akin na yung 2 million. So if you nanatap 2 million, may willing executive dito, ibenta mo na lang daw na 3 million sa kanya at siya na ang bahala sa 2 million. Kaya anong ginawa ng ABS-CBN? Ginawa na nilang tax-free. Because nausa yung ganong ginagawa ng executive nila, kaya yung mga deal ka na mga yun, yung mga deal or not, yung mga yan, tinax-free na ngayon. So, anong nangyayari? After tax na, after 20%. So, yun, yung ano yung magbabay. So, ang gagawin nyo lang doon, if that is the case, kunyari makita nyo, i-remit nyo lang. So, bago ibigay ko sa nanalo, kung 10,000 yung price, 8 lang. Because if you will not do that, what will happen? The law presumes that that is already after tax. So, i-gross nyo rin 10,000 divided by 80%. That will become 12.5. So, the charitable institution will be the one to pay 2.5 for failure to withhold. But donatory, BIR, they will not go after you. They will not go after you when it comes to that amount. Doon na lang sila sa, ano, sa game ka na ba? Deal or no deal. Pinoy Big Brother, the boss. Million doon eh. Pero when it comes, di ba, grabe na. Yun nga lang sa ano eh, sa mga patay. Di ba, nanalo ka sa wet eh. Nanalo ka sa sakla, baklay, tong-its. Di ba, tayo pa yung hinahawal pa ng BIR. Hindi naman. Gusto ko naman din na para yung BIR magpunta pa sa ganong activities. Di ba, there are only few lawyers in BIR, few code examiners. Definitely, they will not go after religious organization. Eh, kita mo naman yung proceeds ginagamit talaga. Di ba? Hindi na para sila. Question na lang. Basta ano lang, ang pangalo ko lang dyan, pag may mga labor dispute, pag-usapan na lang sa loob. Eh, yun lang, diba? As a lawyer, I hate litigation. Other lawyers want litigation. I want compromises. Because they will just, di ba, clamp the dockets of the Supreme Court. They cannot decide more important cases. There are several constitutional cases, issues already raised before the Supreme Court. If we will contribute to those unclogged dockets, most accused drug users are in prison for fabricated charges. And then we will add additional case. Di ba? Yung atin, private right, property right lang yun eh. Yung kanila, right to liberty. And if they will be acquitted, there is no compensation for the damages they have suffered. Like Ms. Conde Masaryl case, Hubert Webb. I'm not in favor of Hubert Webb. I'm not in favor of the Ms. Conde family. But at the end of the day, they are acquitted. Assuming they are the true criminals, they have suffered for 15 years. If they're actually innocent, there is no law providing for compensation to those who have been falsely accused and who have been in prison for 15 years. Sabi nga ni Hubert Webb, hindi ko alam kung sasabi siya na totoo hindi. Sabi niya, napatawad na daw niya yung mga abuse. But actually, the reason for the acquittal, after reading the main case, the main decision, because there are dissenting decisions. If you will read the dissenting opinion, guilty. But if you will read the majority opinion of the court, innocent. So, it's very hard. The reason is that the witness, Jessica Alfaro, is an asset of the NBI. So, what's the problem with that? How come that you are present in the rape case, if you are a drug asset, napaka-coincidental, kasama ka doon. Tingnan siya. Andun siya. A asset ng police for drugs. Andun sa rape case. The other reason is that the sperm cell, the evidence, the DNA evidence regarding sperm cell, was lost by the police officers. Yeah. During the trial, the police officer, the prosecution is asking for DNA testing. But unfortunately, during that time, DNA evidence is not yet admissible. But starting 2009 onwards, DNA evidence has been approved and now discovered ng defense that the evidence is lost. So they ask for the DNA testing. Dati ayaw nila. Ngayon, nag-aasta sila. Nalaman nila, nawala. And third is the certification from the ambassador of US that I think that Hubert Webb is there. But, senator yung tatay niya eh. It's easy. And we cannot charge the ambassador for falsification of public documents. Madali. Sabi, impossible daw, alibay. Senator yung tatay ko. Isang sakay ko sa pag, andun na ako. Balik agad ako dito. Hindi pa, kung nasa Mars, sure na ako. Medyo nasa Mars, probably ilang months. There must be impossibility. Di ba? But ang problema, proved beyond reasonable doubt. He may be guilty, but that was not proven beyond reasonable doubt. Awa naman si Lauro Visconde. At the end of his life, still was not able to deserve that or to obtain the justice. It is yes. Sakit, di ba? Sakit sa mga na naka-witness nun, tsaka sa aming mga bata na nakabasa ng paso pa. Ang hirap ng botohan. Dikit din yung botohan niya, I think 9-6. Bumaligtad na yung isa, 8-7 na, dalawa, di ba? Guilty. Dito sa inyo. Grace po, di ba? 9-6. Grace po. Okay na. So, God bless and good luck. Hopefully, if you have questions, you just add my Facebook account. Ito naman, ready na lang ako. Just message me. If you have questions. Especially, I think si Padam na I'll try to search. And then you message me, madali naman natin sa Facebook, although sobrang dami ng friends. Magpapalawin pa naman. Pero mahalaga yung pag message mo ako, mame-message ko. So I try to search yung hiningin ni Father ng Excel. I try to search. Nahanap din ako sa mga... And then kung may question kayo, I try to answer it from time to time. And then I will also give you the specific provision of the regional DACO. The specific provision of the law, if you want to read provisional in labor code, when it comes to benefits, if you want to determine, you know, ask. Hindi lang, di ba? Pray naman, okay, mag-alala.
We'll pray for you. Thank you po, Attorney, for giving us basic information on something that most of us are not really familiar with. So we hope that our learning today has given us information and an important tool to be used for our purposes in our diocese.